Gentlemen.
Hello everyone, this is Desmond from Edmonton Gamers and I'm here with Clockwork, all the way at Canada Cup. So first of all, I'll let you introduce yourself to everyone. So Clockwork, tell me a little bit of yourself.
My name is Daniel. Go by the name Clockwork. I started playing fighting games when I was really young. My older brothers played. We used to go to the donut shop, play Street Fighter 2, and got it for Super Nintendo. Used all kinds of fighting games. A local arcade, it was golf and stuff, Norwalk. That's where I learned how to play competitively. And a little bit after that, after I graduated high school, I discovered something was off. I couldn't really go there all the time because I couldn't drive.
Yeah.
But I would get a ride over there and sometimes get a ride home, like from the workers at the arcade. And it was at something was off where I learned how to play and get a ride home.
So who was the first, random question, who was your first character you picked in Street Fighter 2?
Street Fighter 2, when I was playing with my brothers, I definitely picked Chun-Li because you could just mash. Well, what I used to do is I used to just mash, which crouch forward, that little crouch and spin kicks you do.
Okay, yeah.
And I would mash like the lightning legs, and anytime they would move for Shoryuken, I would press down roundhouse or sweep, and that's all I knew how to do at the time.
Hey, you gotta start somewhere.
Yeah, for sure. And that's before I could do motions. You know, original Street Fighter 2, it's kind of, the motions are kind of hard, you know, to do, and it wasn't until we had it for Super Nintendo that I learned how to, do fireball.
That's sick. So, so transitioning from Street Fighter 2, kind of let's talk more about like when you started getting into competitive. So you mentioned you kind of like golf. So did you enter tournaments there? Did you kind of go there for casuals?
Yes. So I really started playing competitively, as in going to the arcade and like beating people and that kind of thing. Like Friday, Saturday nights. My first competitive games were Marvel 1 and Tekken 3.
Okay.
So I used to play a lot of Tekken back in the day.
Damn.
Tekken 3 and Tekken Tag. So I entered like maybe one or two tournaments for Marvel 1. I didn't do very well, you know. I was good, but anyone who actually knew about like the meta would crush me. You know what I mean? Like anyone that was picking Red Venom or Blue Machine would crush me.
Who did you use that? Were you Strider?
So I didn't use Strider in Marvel 1. I was one of those guys like, oh man, everyone uses Strider. I'm not gonna use him. I'm not gonna be one of those guys. I was a scrub like that.
Okay.
Even though I thought he looked really cool, but just everybody used him. Everyone used Strider, Wolverine. So I was like, no, fuck that. I used to use Chun-Li and Spider-Man.
Yo,
and now I use a little bit of Ryu too.
I use Spider-Man and Mega Man.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Okay. I was like, yo, I like them. I like these characters. That's when they had that animated Spider-Man series out.
Yeah.
A cool fact about that stuff. It's kind of miscellaneous, but they took the voice actors from the current cartoons then, and they put them into those versus games.
Yeah, dude, you can tell by the voices. Like Wolverine, sounds exactly like Wolverine.
Cyclops.
Cyclops, yeah. I don't know about Rogue, but yeah, some of the other characters, Juggernaut.
Yeah. Oh man, I miss Juggernaut these days.
Yeah, for sure. Man.
So Marvel 1, you said you entered in a couple of times, you know, and you didn't do as well as you wanted to.
Yeah.
Did you enter any Tekken tournaments?
No, I didn't enter any Tekken tournaments. I just used to play it a lot. I used to go to different arcades to play Tekken. But I didn't enter any tournaments for Tekken. I played a little bit of Tekken something that was golf land, but when I started going there regularly, Marvel 2 had already been released.
Okay.
So I already dropped
juicy stuff.
Yeah, I dropped Tekken cold turkey.
Yeah.
So I was playing Marvel 2 at golf and stuff, and then once I learned how to, it was actually before I learned how to drive, I was going to golf line regularly to do my best to get a ride there and get a ride home.
Yeah.
And it was there that, oh shit, Alex Valle plays here. I read about him in Tips and Tricks, and I see the strategy guy. Oh, the scan. I see the scan post, like on, I used to read his posts about, you know, fighting game theory and all that on SRK. That James Chan was there. I used to watch James Chan combo videos on Fighters.net. Fighters.net was how I really got into the scene. I used to post on Fighters.net forums. That was before SRK. And then when SRK became popular, I was over at SRK. And once I learned how to drive, I failed my first test. Stupid ambulance got me. But the night that I passed my test, the afternoon I passed my test, the first thing I did was drive to golf.
Like,
yeah, you know, it like opened up it opened up all these, you know, like, let's say a classic Nintendo design is you see something that you can't access yet, and then you go into the dungeon, you get the special item, and then, oh, I can suddenly go there now. Yeah. Except when I learned how to get my license, like, oh, now I can go to Jack in the Box anytime I want. Now I can go to Ball Fry anytime I want. You know? And so most of my driving early on was to Ball Fry. Route memorized.
It's really cool because it's like it gave you the ambition. Marvel gave you the ambition, or fighting it was to say, gave you an ambition to get your driver's
license. Yeah, absolutely. Right? I need to be able to, self transportation. I can be blind because I wanted to go to golf on every day if I could, even though I didn't. But mostly on the weekends, I didn't want to have to rely on people to, you know, do the thing that I love the most.
No one wants to be that guy.
Yeah, absolutely.
So you mentioned about going to like golf and. Meeting some of these people that you read about or seen in game magazines. So who was the first like player that you were like, oh my god, it's that person?
It was Alex Faye.
Alex Faye?
Yeah. Alex Faye. I used to read about, I had a Tekken 3 strategy guide. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if he was one of the authors or I think he was a contributor, I'm not sure, but you know, I'd read about him and I read about him in Tips and Tricks and like how, you know, some, like, he has like third strike tips or something like that.
Yeah.
And also, when I started, before I knew him, but it was going to Golf Fun, I had seen like the B4 DVDs and all that. I was actually there the night before B4 when they were all practicing at Golf Fun, and they left like the next day.
Wow.
And also, he's a Spider-Man at the time in Marvel 2, you know?
Damn, Spider-Man.
Yeah, dude, this is a long time. I'm talking 2000, this is like 17
yeah.
years ago.
Yeah.
But yeah, Vi was the first. He was the first player that I was really like, starstruck by, and it was like a big deal when he like acknowledged me, like, oh, he knows who I am. And the first time I got to go out with like the cool kids to go eat out after the arcade closed, and everyone was supposed to go eat, and I got invited to go eat.
Yeah.
The first time I got to go over to like his place, and he had an arcade machine that he had one in his kitchen.
What's up, cool
way? Yeah, dude, it was really exciting for me. You know, I'm like a little kid, but I was probably like 18 at the time. You know.
Do you remember the Street Fighter Alpha 3 like American tournament?
I saw all those videos, dude. Okay, and I saw him in videos of Tekken Tag World Championships when Mad Dog Jin came and he was doing the Korean step with Kwarong and MIC was doing the handcuffs and all that. That's how I, you know, all that stuff. Why was like this mythical player to me, and then I met him.
And the battle was like pretty cool.
Yeah, I really look up to those guys. Like Vi, Doug, Scan, I really look up to them. Playing at Golfland is what got me to what I understood to be a high level of play, where I stopped complaining about stuff being cheap or cheesy, right? Because you have that mentality, you're never going to improve.
Yeah.
So it was then that I kind of got rid of that mentality and started playing to win.
So who were some of your early rivals? Like let's talk about the Marvel 2 era, where like that's where that's where I would guess like a major big I guess burst and burn into the fighting. So who were some of like your first rivals that
year? Definitely. All right. So very, 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 very early on, my first rivals were definitely Jose Garcia, Marvel 2. He was really good at Marvel 2. The first time, eventually we became friends, but for, you know, when he used to come to Golf Land, you know, back then it was like an arcade versus arcade type thing. If invaders came to your arcade, you had to defend the turf and all that. He was from Huntington Park, HP, and we used to come over to golf and stuff, and we used to play. You know, we would mad dog each other, oh, he's not that good and all that stuff. And we would play and you'd have heated matches, and these are just regular matches on the arcade machine, but they were heated, you know?
Yeah.
And of course I got to know him, he's super cool, but he was definitely one of my first rivals. And then Combo Fiend, definitely. Combo Fiend was one of those guys, you know, we're kids and we used to like mad dog each other, like good and talk shit on like IRC or SRK forums. But of course, you know, I got to know him, he's cool, but I would say, and then, you know, the guys I used to train with, Shady K and Genghis, of course, they were my rivals as well. They knew how to play against me the best, but I would say those were like, off the top of my head, those were like really my early rivals as far as Marvel 2 goes, and they really shaped my competitive style, or the way I looked at competition, basically. The way I looked at and approached.
So what drew you towards like wanting to play like as your most famous team, Strider,
Yeah.
So what made you go into that era? Like, you want to use these characters. This is where I need to be.
So Marvel 2, I played a lot of different characters. characters that I was best with were like Spider-Man, Omega Red, Strider. I mean, not as many people use Strider back because he's way weaker than he was in Marvel 1. You know, going from transitioning from Marvel 1 to Marvel 2.
Yeah, he had all the hot combos then.
So yeah, of course, he was really, I think he was better in Marvel 2 than Marvel 1, but at the time, you know, you see, oh, his aura bonus is lasting long, and he has really weak defense, so everyone thought he was weak, so people wouldn't use it. They would use Cable and all that. So I was using Strider. I got over it and that. And at the time, I had a huge scrub mentality. I knew about Strider Doom. I'd seen Vi use him and some other people, but I thought, oh, that's a cheat. I'm not going to use that. I'm not going to use Doom Rocks. That's a cheat. That's cheating. They don't put honor, right? And then, you know, so I wanted something at least similar, so I started playing Omega Red Strider Spiral, and I was like, well, if I do Ouroboros and I get to call Spiral at least two times, then the chip damage is similar. But eventually, I was just like, you know, because I really like Dr. Doom, I played him in Marvel Superheroes, right? And I don't remember what it was that really, I think someone at Golf and Stuff said that, yeah, you should probably use this team, you know? And the first, like, three or four Marvel 2 tournaments at Golf Line, I went 0-2. I was just going, I was a pot monster for sure. So I was like, you know, whatever, let me just try Strider Doom and see if I like Omega Red Strider Doom and see if I like it. Yeah. Omega Red Strider Doom, that was the first team where I was really starting to beat good players. And I remember my first really big win was at a Southern Hills Golf Line tournament. I forgot which one. It was really early on, but there was a player back then named Image. He used to play Magneto, Cable, Cyclops. And he was a really good Marvel 1 player, and he was one of the top players at Southern Hills Golf Line. And in one of the tournaments, I played him in like semifinals, and I beat him. And that was the first time, like, people on top didn't lose to no names, right?
Yeah.
And that was the first time I beat someone really good, and I was using Omega Red Strider Doom. And I bet the earliest footage of me ever, if you can find it, I don't know if it's on the internet, but it should. I had it on my website. It was Clock versus Image. And that's the earliest footage you can find of me.
I feel like the one person who would maybe have that.
Zach?
Preppy.
Yeah, Preppy. Yeah, he might have that. But that was like my breakout win, and that's when I realized that I could beat these guys. Like I could at least be on the level. I can give them trouble, you know?
Yeah.
And yeah, the rest is history. Like
he bleeds. He is not a god.
Yeah, exactly. He's sure for a god. He sure has, you know, he's bleeding like a human right now, right?
Yeah.
And so eventually I switched to Senla. I was training. You know, I used to train with my buddy Genghis, and Omega Red has a really hard time with Cable, and he has a really hard time with Psylocke Assist. He can't really pressure safely with Psylocke Assist, so Genghis, he was the best Sentinel at the time. He played Sentinel in a crazy way, so I picked up Sentinel along the way sometime in 2001, and I kept using the team ever since.
That's the transition for you from, like, rocking with Omega Red, etc., etc. And I guess as the meta also started evolving, and that Cali getting better and better, so there was a lot of NorCal, SoCal rivalries back in the day. So did they ever do any 5v5s? Were you ever a part of that?
I think we ever did any like official like NorCal versus SoCal stuff. It was more like they would come to our tournaments, we would go to their tournaments.
Yeah.
I remember one of the big wins I had in NorCal was this guy named Fluffy XXL, and he was, you know, I guess he was considered a top player at the time, and it was like a big deal when I beat him, because I like creamed him, and no one had ever seen like Omega Red and Strider Doom played like that, and I remember everyone was going nuts. That was my big NorCal. I mean, I lost the tournament, obviously, but I think I did love that tournament. I beat that guy, who was really good at the time. It wasn't any official like setting that kind of stuff up or exhibitions. It was more like we go to their tournaments, they come to ours, and we'll see what happens.
Okay. So transitioning from there into Marvel 3, I guess it was pretty easy mentality, like I'm gonna pick Strider, I'm gonna pick Dr. Doom. Right? Then you went and played Phoenix.
Yeah.
So can you walk me through why you went that way?
So when before Marvel 3 came out, they had character trailers where they would show what the character could do and all that. I wasn't really sold on Marvel 3 at the time because I heard about the button layout. I was like, what? It's 30 buttons? It's lame, you know? And I wasn't really excited for the game. I didn't really pay too much attention. And I saw the Phoenix trailer. For some reason, Phoenix trailer, it was around that time it was getting close to launch, so I started getting kind of excited. And then I saw the Phoenix trailer, and she looks so sick that she turned into Dark Phoenix. And I was like, oh, that's so sick. I have to play her. And Strider wasn't in vanilla, but Doom was. So, you know, I had to deal with that. So I used, very first team I used was Doom, Shenko, Phoenix. And I realized right away that Shenko, she's one of my favorite Capcom characters, but she wasn't really my style. Like I felt like she was a bit too slow for me. And
it's her first versus game.
Yeah, and she was, you know, Vampire Saber, she's not that slow. She is in Marvel 3. So I switched immediately to Amy, who I really liked, and I picked Doom, Amy, Phoenix. And, you know, just scumming people. I didn't know that she was gonna be the best character in the game, you know? Or at least one of the best characters. Yeah, she's definitely the best character in the game.
I remember hearing that you said you almost prefer to play Phoenix first. Like you were fine even if you didn't have her.
No, I didn't like to play her first, but I was really comfortable with Jean Grey. Because when you play Dark Phoenix, especially early on where it was just easy to get hit with a random super, playing Dark Phoenix was scary because you could just get random supered and die, you know? So I felt really confident with regular Phoenix, but for some reason Dark Phoenix I kind of played scared, and that's what helped me in Ultimate, because I didn't really play Phoenix so much in Ultimate, but I still knew that how scared Phoenix players were when they were Dark Phoenix. Tried to, you know, I understood that because I was a Phoenix player, so I felt like I did good against Phoenix players because I played her.
So then you eventually traded her out for Virgil.
Yeah, well, so in Ultimate I used Doom, Amy, Strider. I got Strider.
Yeah.
And that team, the team composition just didn't work.
Yeah, you had Amy, that Strider.
Yeah, like the problem with that team is it was too weak, and if you're gonna play a Doom, Amy team, it has to be point character Doom, Amy. I had to play Doom, Amy, Strider. I wasn't going to play Strider, Doom, Amy. It's too weak, so I need... The thing is, like, when I first saw the trailer for Virgil, I was like, oh yeah, I'm definitely playing this character. He has Ouroboros. But I really liked Amy, and I shed the air switch. So I really tried to make it work. But I couldn't get the results that I wanted. And I switched to Virgil, and it was kind of a rough transition. I didn't know what I was doing for a long time. And at some point, it clicked. And I felt like after like a year or two, I thought that I had the best Virgil. Maybe not the best X-Factor Virgil because I didn't really play X-Factor Virgil that much. I played X-Factor Strider, but as far, you know, I used to start Virgil.
Yeah.
And I felt like my Virgil was probably the strongest. Maybe not X-Factor 3, but just in general, I thought my Virgil was the strongest eventually.
So now, 17 years later, we've moved into... We went from, you know, Street Fighter 2 with the bros, right? We went from Tekken 3 and Marvel 1 with Spider-Man, right? And now we're moving into, like I said, 17 years later, we got Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, right? And, I mean, it gets positive and negative feedback. Some people like the looks, some people don't. What is something about Marvel 3 that's, like, got you so captivated?
It's gonna be Marvel Infinite?
Marvel
Infinite. Yeah, sorry. I think it's the tag system. I really love the tag system.
Everyone can get it in.
The tag system, and I think that it just opens up. So there's a huge difference. You know, the transition from Marvel 1 to Marvel 2 is a huge change. Marvel 2 to Marvel 3, a huge change. Marvel 3 to Infinite is the biggest change, I feel, in the way the game plays. And for me, like, you know, I'm all about potential, being creative and freestyling and all that, and I feel like this game, it does a really good job of letting players really explore their style. As long as they choose to, you don't have to explore your style, you can just pick, what, like Dante, or, you know, whatever, or Ultron Dor, whatever, and do your thing and do whatever else, do what you see other players doing, but if you want to, you know, if you want, I feel like the game really allows you to explore your own style as a player.
a lot of creativity, artistic.
Yeah, you know, people joke around because, you know, early on, a lot of top players are like, oh, it's so creative. And everyone's like, oh, you guys are stupid and lame. But
yeah,
it's true. It's true. I say that without being paid a dime, you know? Like, that's why I like the game. And, you know, I'm not going to play it if I don't like it. And I really love this game. And I'm really interested to see how the meta evolves, how the game gets patched, the new characters, and how my own style develops.
So what? Sorry, last couple questions here.
Yeah.
So Strider was a shoo-in, right? No Dr. Doom. You got Gamora.
Yeah.
So what was it about Gamora that made you want to just, like, you know, start playing with guns?
You know, it sounds stupid, but I just really love her spacesuit, dude. She has like the white spacesuit. She looks so sick. I think she looks better in the game than she does in the movies.
I guess.
Yeah, she looks awesome. Like, I just the white, and then she has like a Metroid look, or a Samus look, or a Mass Effect look. I really like her outfit. It's cool.
It's cool.
And luckily, you know, her and Strider, they work well together, and you know, they story team. Yeah,
yeah.
So ended up working out. I don't know if I'll stick with her for the long haul. I'm not sure if she's my style, but I like her a lot. But the thing is, like, since Doom is not in the game, I feel like I should shop around, because if he was in the game, then I wouldn't shop around. I would be character locked for life, Strider Doom. But since he's not in the game, I almost feel like I should exercise my freedom in that, you know, to try other characters or try more Strider, you know, maybe some of the new DLC that comes out, and Gamora, and whatever else.
So aside from Dr. Doom, is there any characters you would like to see, or either returning to our new characters tomorrow?
I would like to see Omega Red, I would like to see Spiral, Captain Commando, any characters from Breath of Fire.
I've been thinking about Breath of Fire 3.
Yeah, I'd do 1, 2, or 3. I didn't play 4 or whatever else, but I played 1, 2, and 3. Any characters from Breath of Fire, yeah, Captain Commando, Omega Red especially. I really like Omega Red. I'd like to see Sentinel. And then, you know, it would be nice to see all the characters that everyone else has for. I think off the top of my head, those are the characters that I personally like to see.
Yeah. So, I mean, is there any changes you want to see happening? Because a lot of people are saying, you know, they want reality stuff to get hurt, they want to get pissed, or everyone to get pissed, but, you know. So, like, do you think the game should evolve to a certain point before you start making drastic changes like that?
So the way I look at it is, I don't really care to discuss what I want to see change, because it's like, it's not up to me, right? So it's not help. Like, I feel like a lot of times when people have discussions like this, they're not necessarily talking about things that should change to make the game better. They're just basically complaining about things that they don't like, right? And that's not going to help me as a player. So I usually don't really think about what I want to see change or whatever. I look at it as what can I do to overcome this or whatever. I will say that it's important to let the player base push the game's meta instead of having stuff change. It's like, when you start changing stuff, you're assuming that you knew, you know, what it was supposed to be or what it wasn't supposed to be. Like, even I have to imagine, even the game devs, like, when they make fighting games are so complex. Maybe there'll be things in the game that they didn't even understand that were possible, even though they designed it, you know. So I'm a firm believer of, you know, human potential or whatever, and the potential for the player base to really be creative with the evolution of the meta.
That's a good answer.
that's just how I feel, right?
That's definitely perfect. All right, well, I think we ate up enough of this man's time. We're at 23 minutes. All right, but this has been Desmu rocking it with Clockwork. Is there anything you want to say to any upcoming players out there?
Just stick with it. Pick characters that you like. Pick characters and play a style that's going to keep you playing. Don't worry so much about winning, but if you want to win, then for sure, do